And who was heading this worldwide chaos? It's given in the case.
So
US division heads. So there is very clearly written, it's being headed by someone, it's a small committee. So who were the members of the WWE? So members of maybe one or two of the, some of the SBUs? Functional heads of in US and divisional heads. What is the difference between a functional head and a divisional head? What do you think they will be doing? Can you be a little bit more elaborate? Example with examples, can you say please? So here, what are the products that they are making? Medical products and diagnostics. And over there also, it might be that medical product, maybe there would be a smaller division for surgical equipment. There would be another division for maybe diabetes care. Huh? Isn't it? So there will be those heads. Isn't it? And so if you see Exhibit 3, they've given you some examples of all their different divisions. You want to have the case? Exhibit 3. Isn't it? Now my question is, so there might be a situation cytometry systems, MP3 might be sample collections, so all those kind of products which are within sample. Someone MP4 might be infection systems. Are you following me? NMP1 and NMP2 might be the new products, medical products which are in the pipeline. Who takes those R&D decisions? SBUs. Who used to do the R&D? So who's deciding? Just be presidents. Page 3, read teams which met quarterly. Read that paragraph. SBU or WWE, which teams are meeting?
WWE.
So SBUs are making R&D decisions?
No.
Huh? Very clearly written, who's doing what? Are you all following it? to know who's doing what work first. Similarly, diagnostic product, let's say there is a depth of three products, and NDP1 is a new product, new diagnostic product. Now, can you please tell me, based on your common sense, like after you've understood what kind of strategy, after they would have gone international, which kind of products do you think will be manufactured in which geography? Let me see how we can think. Then, do you think everything will be produced in all the factories? Which ones do you think? Because they have also set up factories in different locations. Why do you think they have opened up those other four factories? What do you think would be manufactured in the US? What do you think would be manufactured in Mexico? And it was just focus on US. In US, let's say. And in US market, they will not be selling MPU. Medical product 1, 2, 3, 4. Where will they will not produce it there. So where will they get it from? So you tell me where. So this, do you think this will be produced here?
Yes.
This is the least complex product, let's say. And maybe this is the most complex medical product. But we were just discussing if you do that, the transportation cost, import duty, what kind of strategy are you adopting? Research, how much research you think will be going for medical product? I am now in NP1 to NP6. What would be produced there? If you would have been maybe responsible for taking these decisions, what would you three of you would have produced there? In USA? US, first focus on US. So where will you sell medical products 1, 2 in US, how will you sell them? You'll get out of that market?
No. But it's in Europe.
See, there are two things. You're playing the simulation, you have to understand. You are producing and you are also demand selling. And there are two independent activities. So if you are thinking of selling, where are you going to get it from? Outsource or in-house products? And you are taking those decisions there. Isn't it? So my question is right. Why you will be selling all of them? And these new ones might be the ones which you are planning to launch because of your R&D. This one is also something that you are planning to launch because of your R&D. So, where would you produce them? Where would you be selling them? So which one? Okay, so all these you want them to be produced in US?
NDP1.
No, let's go one by one. Here, what will you be producing in US? Of all these 7 different or 8 different alternatives?
All of them?
No, diagnostic product would take. You yourself now, some time back, said that you will adopt a low-cost strategy. So what will you do? Okay, let's come to Mexico. We'll come back to US a bit later. What do you think will be the factories that are there in Mexico, what do you think they will be producing? Why? All of them? What happened? What do you say? What do you think they will be? Why not this? Where is Mexico on the geography of US? Have you seen?
South America.
It's in South America.
In the southern part of the North America.
It can easily be considered as another state of US. So, most probably, these products which you might have stopped production in US, which are where you are adopting a low-cost strategy, I just told you, these might have, why Mexico and Brazil both there? Because Mexico has cheaper labor. Because of Mercosur and NAFTA and all those agreements, tariffs are not there between, or when not there between US and Mexico. As I said, it's like another state of US. So you might have outsourced the factories or production of the least complex products, which you might have stopped producing in US so that you can also cater to the demand of US. Because producing those in US might make you uncompetitive. Huh? What did you want to say? Share it with us also.
In medical products, which are very low cost, it can be made in the states of the US, while the costlier products can be made across the countries, and they can be also.
Costlier ones will be made across US or costlier?
Costlier ones, like, based on the technology. Let's say DP, the diagnostic product, they require more technology, they can produce within the US only.
Because why would you not be comfortable sharing your patents or know-hows? Not only because of this institutional voids that we discussed that day, just scared what if maybe a competitor or another JV partner steals your license, where will you go and fight with him? So the confidence is poor in underdeveloped or advanced for developing countries. So that's why you would not be comfortable sharing the patents or know-hows with other companies, other countries where the institutional voids are less. So that is where now if you see the parallel to institutional voids is coming. Brazil, maybe, again something similar, maybe one or two of the diagnostic products which are less, least complex. Europe, maybe all, and even all, because you want to be, or maybe this two, three might be exported from US if they are very complex. Japan, maybe similar. Yeah, you can do that, but I'm saying you have to also take into consideration. And all the research, new products would be most probably done in-house in US. Are you all following it? Now let's say, you tell me now. After you are here like this, so one, how will you decide how many units to produce where? Achha, before that, spend 5 minutes reading.
So that financial.
No, those are not required. There's a strategy. Read exhibit 6 and 7 within 5 minutes. I hope you have read this. Yes, madam. You're reading on your phone or on the case? Exhibit 6, I told you, you're reading exhibit 3. Huh? My eyesight, thankfully, is still sharp. Okay, right? Both exhibit 6-7. Tell me, so what did you understand? What is happening in exhibit 6? Who is doing it? What is happening? Does it look something familiar? What is this? One. This is nothing but what? Macro and macro and micro environment analysis. Huh? Yes, no. Why were you doing it? Yes, I think in the second or third class we were discussing. Who is doing it? WW is doing this. Who is doing it? Who do you think is doing it? Is the SBUs who are doing it? You read exhibit 7 or no? A diagram. So who is doing it? So what are they doing? They are doing an environment scanning. So let's say India. There will be a strategic research unit. So what is the country manager going to do? He will be looking at maybe what? Yes? Will be assessing the market. What is he trying to figure out? He is trying to maybe figure out how many new hospitals are opening up. He'll be trying to. Who are the competitors? All those things that you read in exhibit 6. He'll be trying to figure out what are the new products that maybe the competitors are planning to launch. He'll be trying customer needs. He'll be developing relationships with the existing hospitals. Why will he be doing that? Because it's a part of the planning process. So let's say he will be preparing an Excel sheet that, well, this is the product portfolio of my company. All these products are there. As per my estimate, I am forecasting, or I feel that these are the sales numbers that we will generate or we will meet. Isn't that what is happening? Just see it. Based on their primary assessment of the environment, they are trying to figure out, even if let's say they don't have manufacturing facilities, it's not that everyone has manufacturing facilities, all the SBUs. Don't have. And even if you have manufacturing facilities, you just saw that maybe not all the products of your product portfolio are manufactured in that region. Are you all understanding me? So every year during the planning process, each of these SBUs, when does that happen? Starts in December. So maybe within a month they would have done this. So 31 Excel sheets, each with their respective, so let's say they will say that, well, there are two new products, I am taking maybe with the interaction with the worldwide team, would have told them that there are two new products which are going to be launched. How many numbers can you sell? Huh? This is what they are doing after doing the initial boundary scanning, environment scanning. So 31 Excel sheets. By what time are these all 31 Excel sheets coming back? So in your game, the demand forecasting page is what is happening here, isn't it? What are you trying to do there? You're trying to forecast the demand. Isn't this what you are doing? You don't have any idea what will happen in the future. You are maybe reading a little bit from the market outlook. But here, obviously in the field, you have to do it all by yourself. So you are doing the demand forecast. Yeah. Then what are you supposed to do? What are you doing in the game? Production. So you will go back to those factories. Where are all these factories located? Are these five different locations? Now let's say for MP1, the installed capacity is 15,000. That's the maximum that you can produce. This one. Are you all following me? Now let's say in each of the factories you can produce some numbers or whatever, and some part of your product portfolio is done. So your total installed capacity across all geographies or for LP1 is, let's say, 15,000. Across all geographies, installed capacity to manufacture LP2 is 25,000. The new products that you are planning to launch, you have actually set up a factory where 5,000 units would be launched. You set up a factory for new product 2, NFP2, where only 500 can be done. And similarly, for the most complex diagnostic product, you have set up a factory where only 50 units can be done. So what will you do? Who will take the decision? SBU will take the decision. They will all want to move. They will take the decision? They have already taken the decision and have given you the numbers. What is happening in Exhibit 7? What is that process? Have you understood that process? So these numbers maybe you have been back for 3 years. 3 seats. Would have given it. What is happening? It all has to come back to the SMC, Strategic Management Committee. So consolidation has to happen.
Yes, so the Strategic Management Committee needs
to. So who will decide now? 15,000 is your total installed capacity. But the total demand that has been generated by all the 31 SBUs is 20,000. Who will get what? Who will decide? SBU. Now you understand why was the planning process required and why did Ray Gilmart initiate this process to start with? Why? So that you have a better picture across all your geographies. You can coordinate their work. You can synchronize it. So who will now decide? Can you decentralize? Who started the discussion? There is decentralization.